Welcome back, everybody. See Story Cup number 4. Apologize for the delays. We had some internet issues, which means fundamentally we can't play the games. But thankfully, the stream was still going. We didn't have that drop. So you got to see some cool behind-the-scenes stuff. It's been really fun so far. And we're going to engage with more fun stuff, beginning with Wreckful and Stan Sifka. I'm joined by Eloise and Gara, two fellow Tempo Storm members. What's up? How has your tournament been so far, Eloise?
Complicated English. What are you talking about?
Well, for Eloise's mind, because she hates losing, she didn't actually play in this tournament. But Gar, you advanced into the top 8 as well, man. Good job.
Yeah. How was the tournament for you, Frodo?
Dude, the tournament's been crazy. It's been epic.
You shouldn't ask that.
Now he starts talking, you know, we could just, you know, listen.
Yeah. I mean, I could talk a lot about it for a long time. But the summary is, it's been great. Been fantastic. I've been enjoying a lot so far. And I think the best part about this is just how we moved to a new venue. But in the end, it still feels kind of like Home Story Cup, don't you think, Gara?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Sea Story Cup. I apologize.
And it also feels pretty good to win, you know? Be here, enjoy all the stuff, and advance in the tournament.
Yeah, good stuff. That means only one player remaining from Tempo Storm has yet to prove his medal in the round 16, as Wreckful. And he's going up against one of the hardest opponents, I think, in this tournament. It's Stan Sifka. And Stan Sifka has been on a tear recently. He's been slowly adjusting to Hearthstone more and more over the coming months. And now that he's been playing full-time for a while, he's just been destroying it. He's a really good opponent.
Yes.
I think... Yes, Stan Sifka also, like, he qualifies for WCA. He's on a roll. He's extremely good. He's practice partner of Life Coach and Thijs.
Yeah.
And even RDU, like, with the best players.
That's
and
right.
He's, like, bringing experimental decks, but they're also, like, really strong. What is so funny?
Why is he grinning? You're grinning at him so evilly, like... What? You know what you are? You're like the girl that's smiling when the building's like exploding or something on fire.
Good, man.
What? I only smile at John Cena.
You really enjoyed that that explanation. Yeah, Stan Sifka is good.
Yeah,
he's a good player.
Good.
Absolutely.
Pretty good.
I like that he also is a roper. You know, he's a guy that really plays to his strengths of thinking through turns. But one thing that I think Stan Sifka is like the second coming of Life Coach in a way. He takes a long time on his turns, and he always plays Handlock for some reason, for better or for worse. I think, is there any other player in the entire tournament that's played Handlock?
I think he actually had a Handlock mirror against someone. If I could just remember.
Is there anybody remaining in a tournament that's playing Handlock? Because
I don't think so.
He's one of the few, if not the only one. I can't really think anyone off the top of my head. And like right now, it's not really that good of a Handlock meta. I mean, Druid is really good, Paladin's really good, and Hunter is being played, and it's like those are like Handlock's worst matchups.
Yeah.
Yes.
And even like Tempo Mage and Freeze Mage got better, but Handlock didn't really.
I think that Dreadful is just here to gamble.
He is. I mean, he's playing a lot of poker these days. And in fact,
he's
such a bad influence, man. Like, he's teaching guys like Oskaka, who prior to Sea Story Cup wasn't really playing poker at all. And now he's getting him to all in on pre-flop hands with Omaha. And it's like, that's the kind of stuff that you do when you're like 35 and you've missed like the best years of your life and you want to relive it through some adrenaline rush. So you just go to some casino and all in pre-flop. That's what you do.
He wants to teach me poker.
He just won the world championship. Why does he have to do that? He wants to teach you poker. Actually, girls are always, they have very good beginner's luck, generally speaking. I always play like craps or something with a girl at a casino because they usually are really good.
But you are a girl too.
That's right.
Yeah.
I'm speaking from experience. See?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, I flipped that around at you.
Yes.
You weren't ready for that one, huh?
Mm-mm.
That's right. Well, you better be on your toes, Eloise. I'm going to defend myself this time around. All right, so I think we're going to game number one. Before we do that, let's talk about promotion. I actually promised I wouldn't forget it, and I did forget it. So let's go to facebook.com/taketv. Click on this Sea Story Cup for raffle. We're giving away something on stream, and we're giving away some cool stuff. We're giving away two chairs that are from Max Nomic, thanks to Need for Seat. One to the EU, one to the USA. You can be the big winner. But if you don't win those, you can also win some Hearthstone packs. So you can afford, well, if you open 50 packs, you might be able to afford maybe a tenth of the Control Warrior. And then you also can get one of these hoodies as well. It's a Hearthstone-themed one. All you have to do is enter your name, your country, and your email address. Full
good
name,
stuff.
Though.
Good stuff.
That's right.
Good enter. Stuff.
We,
good
maybe
stuff.
We should show them one day how to do it. Oh, man. Oh, no. We waited. We waited for half an hour for this series.
Oh.
For a half an hour game. Here we go. Warrior versus Warrior.
We're here for a match.
I should go to the toilet before this match starts.
There is a really... Whoa, what was that? That was like some kind of weird ad on Rekful's screen. He's probably trying to get himself pumped up before the match.
Maybe he's was on a betting site. Betting on himself.
Betting on himself to win. Oh. I don't know, man. That would be very Rekful. but it, you know, in all honesty, though, how much is Rekful really prepared? These Warrior mirror matchups are really intricate.
Yeah.
Before coming to this tournament, I said there's one matchup I absolutely do not want to play, no matter. Like, I'll try to avoid it at the highest priority, and that's Control Warrior mirrors, because they are so complicated with all the small little intricacies, like how you use shield block or don't, or how you use your brawls or don't, or how you use your removals. You know, how do you time Dr. Booms? And like, there's all these kinds of things. And so, like, I asked Saiyan, I was like, Saiyan, so how do I play this matchup? And he gave me like 20 paragraphs of like, this is what you need to do, and you'll win.
Oh, 20 paragraphs. Well, I thought there's only one line. Like, well met, armor up, and repeat 20 times.
Yeah, and then tank up. The best is, one of the best chat things that was going on for a while was like, Resident Sleeper, Justicar, Resident Sleeper, tank up, Resident Sleeper, I'm out of cards! I thought that was really funny.
Can we fast forward 20 turns?
No, this is what we do to cast. You have to be entertaining for the entire time, Eloise. And you don't have YouTube videos to rely on.
Okay.
So you signed up for the wrong gig.
Okay, Brodan, can we talk about your boyfriend to entertain people?
Well, he couldn't make it to Seed Story Cup, so I played in his stead. But you know what? He's at home waiting for me. With a big box of chocolates and an even bigger forehead.
I hope Stan brought enough food for this match.
Enough fruits? Yeah, dude. Stan Sipka eats a lot of fruits.
At least I think you've done better than him. Than your boyfriend.
Actually,
I don't think he can make this far.
Raynad in Seed Story Cup 2 actually got to the top 8. I believe he lost to 6-0. But the really funny thing about the second thing is, that also means you probably shouldn't really play Acolyte either. So you saw that Stan Sifka had the chance to play Acolyte. And normally, in control matchups, you want to draw and have card advantage. But specifically with Warrior, you have access to so much removal that it's almost irrelevant how many cards you draw, because again, you're that much deeper into fatigue. Realistically, what you're going to try to do is leverage your health total with weapons. So like Fiery War Axe, you're going to be hitting things twice with. So that way you can actually have use of that life as opposed to just being at 75 when fatigue starts.
I don't know why he didn't develop the War Axe. I mean, he knows his opponent doesn't play Harrison.
He wants to play something until his hand is full.
Yeah.
Before his hand is full, I don't think he will play anything.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I'm wondering why he's taking so long, though. Maybe he's trying to get in Stan Sifka's head. Or the other option is we have the POVs flip.
Yeah. Wait a second. Let me burn some rope first.
That's right. Well, dude, Rekful, look at him. He's busting out the paper and the pen, and he's drawing lines and circles. He's trying hard. By the way, Stan Sifka did play that shield block.
He's here for business.
Yeah. He's trying real hard, man.
Not just a gamba.
All right, so coin into the Shield Maiden. That's because I guess he doesn't want Shield Maiden to get answered by weapons. Again, it works both ways. You're trying to get value off of your weapons, and you're trying to deny your opponent from getting easy value.
But I heard that the first one to play Justicar has the more advantage.
It does. They do, generally speaking.
It was just so likely as a weapon. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's the best time to play a Justicar. Probably like when you get the double armor turn.
No, that now is fine. Now is perfectly fine. I mean, sure, you lose it, but...
It just dies to the weapon.
Yeah, but, I mean, Justicar is not really there for the actual, like, value. It's like, the earlier you can get the tank ups, the more health you have to play with, and then use, like, Death Spite on, like, Shield Maidens.
I still think that you're trying to get some value out of it, like, playing it behind a Belcher.
Yeah, I guess so.
Or something like that. Like, the opponent has the weapon already developed. He could just, like, weapon it down and then play a Dr. Boom. You don't want...
That's true. But you know he's playing stuff like Bash, so no matter what you do, he can sit on this weapon all day and get value off of it. And he's at 10 life, so he's going to be able to shield slam stuff. I definitely see what you're saying, though. It's definitely tricky. And Sansifka is also at the point where he's drawn a lot of his removals and his small things to keep him alive to the late game, but he doesn't have any threats. And that could be actually disaster. Because Rekful could just keep lining up threats and eventually Stan Sifka just needs to drop bombs.
And I also think since they implemented Justicar for Control Warrior, there's really no way that you can close out the game earlier. It has to go to fatigue. It's just way too much armor per turn.
Yeah. So, there's always this weird thing of like, do I play Dr. Boom on empty board and give him value for Brawl? Because
this is the best turn for Dr. Boom. There's no better turns.
Usually, having Dr. Boom answer a minion in this matchup is actually okay too. Because then they get less value off their Brawl. Because this would be a Brawl turn.
I think also that we saw double BGH in Stanciska's Control Warrior. That's like...
That's really big. That's really big.
That's big in the mirror.
Yeah.
And he doesn't have it here. Feels good, man. For Rekful. Feels bad, man. For Stan Sifka.
Because, I mean, Boom doesn't really do anything here. It's just like, it just gets eliminated, too.
But we already just seen a Shell Slam.
This
makes sense.
It's like, there's so much... That's true. I guess if you see a Shell Slam, maybe you feel like he has less chances for removal. But your opponent hasn't played anything with, like, he had 6 mana left, and he didn't play a single threat after killing with the shield slam.
Stanciska's hand is really bad, though. Like, he drew all 4 weapons.
Yeah.
It's, like, very clunky. He has both Taskmasters, the Owl, Acolyte. It's like,
yeah.
No threats are coming out. It will be probably very, very difficult to deal with them.
The Death Spite, Death Spite's a good draw, but you don't want all of that.
Yeah, yeah. You want to have like a combination of
right,
minions
right,
and
right.
weapons, but not all weapons.
And and Rekful's still drawing threats.
Now it's a very good turn for Justicar now. If he don't play Justicar this turn, it probably be a little bit late.
Yeah, sure. I mean, if you have weapons killing one card for one card, just even having Deathbite hit the 2/2, it's perfectly fine.
Belcher's also fine. It's not like the worst in the world.
Belcher would
like
be
the way how your opponent plays, you're like wondering because he hasn't played the threat yet, so his hand must be very reactionary.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, second shield block. I mean, Sansifka could start feeling like he wants to actually get to his threats, but you know, Death Spite into armor up is also okay without using shield block.
Oh my God! If he plays Isera here, the chance that it will survive is pretty high.
Right, and he's used execute and shield slam. Although I wonder if Rekful feels like he wants to hit face to reduce the armor count.
It's time
count.
To gamba, man.
I don't know. You can still play.
You
can still play Sludge Belcher and kind of evaluate. But actually, it does die to a Death Spite.
Oh yeah, he's gamba. Gamba boys.
Wow.
He don't want
Rekful's
to fall to sleep in this match.
He's going all in.
And he'll slam off the top.
It's like you have it or you don't.
Oh.
Whoa.
Ooh, he's got an owl. So that's always interesting. He also can draw into the removal piece too. I think one of the best things for Wreckful is that it hits this Acolyte for one.
He has to silence it. That feels pretty good, man. Oh. Interesting. Oh, no. Oh, that's so...
That's risky. Like
that's... Yeah. He doesn't have a brawl as well, you know?
Right. Well, first of all...
Like, if he plays a taunt, double... Yeah. Double Belcher, boys.
Even double Belcher, yeah.
Even against Brawl, that's pretty good, man.
Yeah, this is a perfect turn for Belcher.
It is. Not to mention that Sylvanas also...
Gamba paying
yeah,
off.
Yeah, could get just like dreamed or something too.
He could also play Belcher, Armorsmith, and Laughing Sister. And smoke it up.
What yeah, Belcher reduce the value off? Of like things that are getting yeah. stolen.
It's like a mix.
Laughing Sister is surprisingly clutch in this matchup.
Oh yeah, you can steal Acolyte, that's also good. Uh-huh.
He has to play more minion.
I'm okay with not playing Acolyte, though.
Oh, he's going for the Gamba.
What?
He's going for the Gamba. Come on, Wreckful. You can't Gamba every
You're
time.
Crazy.
He's going for the Gamba.
What does he do that? What's going to happen?
He's going to Gamba.
What's going to happen?
He's like, I'm here to Gamba.
And, I mean, he can't even shield spam.
Oh, looks like. Oh, no.
Wow.
Oh, man.
No.
Oh, no.
No.
Come on,
oh.
It's like 25%.
Hey, no. Wow.
This is so funny.
Did he just give up his way to win the game here?
This is so funny.
He legitimately could have just sat on Ysera for a while.
Oh, he's playing around a lot of stuff.
Oh, no. Wreckful wants to leave. He can tell he's done. Yeah.
We can tell from Stasif because he has a lot of ways to suicide someone else. Like, he can... God. Crew task BJH, and now he can shell slam his own Sylvanas.
Oh god, and now he's making him draw more cards.
How could you not see that line of playing coming?
Wow, that is like the real punish though. Like when you do a move like that, it's like the world, like justice has been served. You tempted fate. You tempted fate, and you got burned. Wreckful's like Bradley Cooper from Limitless without the pills, man.
It's okay.
That's exactly what Wreckful is. This is actually a decent Baron Genin value. Although he doesn't need it.
No.
Baron Genin doesn't really do much in this matchup, though, fundamentally.
It's a pretty damn good Acolyte trade, I would say.
Yeah, but he's drawing a little bit too many cards. Oh, jeez. Well, you know what?
His hand is still pretty damn good.
Yeah, he can Shredder and develop the weapon.
And if Stanciska never draws the Justica, he might even close out the game before Fatigue. There's hope.
No, absolutely. There is room to be aggressive in this matchup. People forgot that maybe about a year ago, there was a school of thought by many top Control Warrior players that you should play aggressive in this matchup.
Yeah.
But then with Justicar changed a lot of that.
Yeah.
But you have to draw it.
Well, Justicar is up for both, so now they're just tanking up. And keeping that armor count low is pretty relevant. Shield Slam is nowhere near as impactful when you can't, like, you know.
I think... Yeah, both play Alexstrasza, so...
Ah, so he silences, and that means Sylvanas gets better, too. Now, I would really want Wreckful to protect this Laughing Sister and make Brawl the only way you can kill it. Because I think the 3 damage gives you lots of flexibility with this weapon to like even kill like an Alexstrasza, because it gives you like 5 damage on a Deathbite. Also, because you go first, Wreckful, I believe, went first this game, and I think it's indicated by the life. You have a huge life advantage because you're hitting up the armor up button first. You can use Grommish as like removal. As the game goes on.
It's so tempting to play double Belcher.
Oh, he doesn't want to give any brawl value at all.
Yeah, brawl.
But I think that Laughing Scissor is actually pretty good to keep around. There's no way to treat the ladies, Wreckful.
So Wreckful forces it to late game no matter what as well.
Yeah, I guess so. Sorry, I was reading the chat. They said Metapod value. That's pretty funny, man. It is funny, Eloise. If you had an ounce of sense of humor. If you look at what Wreckful has to... Not at all. Oh, an Unstable Ghoul. So I was kind of wondering if Wreckful had also a greedier list, because he had Ysera, but the Unstable Ghoul
is
kind of like one for one for the Owl.
Unstable Warrior in this game.
Yeah. Unstable Ghoul is pretty powerful against a lot of the early game aggression, but against this, there it is.
Double BJH, but
yeah. That's another thing too. Saiyan told me that you really want to try to save Berengeddon for the like after the BGH, because that's actually a really good snipe the other way around, as opposed to letting your first Berengeddon get sniped. Or sorry, your Berengeddon get sniped by the first BGH. And again, this is going to be completely down to attrition and value, but the quality of hand Recful has is much better versus outside of the shield slam and BGH, there's not really a lot of power. And Recful's playing around a Phantom Brawl. He might just play Ghoul and then
should continue to gamble, man. He started it.
He started it?
Yeah.
So how would he gamble?
Yeah, like not Sylvanas. Play around Brawl.
I'll play around. Yeah.
That's how you gamble, man.
Yeah, I wouldn't think that's bad. But like he used his second Death Spite swing on a slime. So like that's already stuff that's like you don't really want to be doing. You want to be using Death Spite second hit to kill
a
Shield
threat.
Maiden or Berengeddon and using your insane life pool to be able to do it.
Do you think Recful can draw some more cards because he's playing very aggressive?
I think he is tilting, man.
He can play Alkalite last turn.
He's tilting.
He's some more cards rushing.
Yeah, I think so. But
Recful lost everything.
Yeah.
Except this game.
I like it. I like it. We're hanging in there. We're on Team Recful. But I mean, I really like the way Stan Sivka's...
He just doubled his life pool.
He's at 60 health. I really like the way that Stan Sivka is managing his resources, because it's very easy to think, well, I abide by these principles, like never shield block or like don't really cycle stuff or don't draw. But he's kind of like evaluating what his opponent's doing and then staying relevant in the conversation by having just enough to survive. And that's going to really help, because in about 1.5 hours, you're going to realize, when Stan Sivka finally draws the second half of his deck, you're going to realize that Stan Sivka is like top decking big bomb after big bomb after big bomb. And Recful is going to be drawing like his shield slam and maybe like other stuff, his brawl.
Taskmaster.
Yeah, his Taskmasters, etc. Well, there's two minions on the board. This might be one of the better brawls that you have. He's already used Boom. Realistically, it comes down to some stuff like this. Like, if you feel like you need to brawl on a board.
The thing is, to have any pressure against your opponent, you need like more than 4 power on board.
That's true, because you have tank up.
And that will automatically overextend into a brawl.
Yeah, that's a really good point. So if you add Arborsmith, that's 5 damage. Yeah. That is a 47 turn clock.
Exactly.
Sorry, excuse me, 51.
In 18 turns, it's down to 29 life.
Oh, man.
Nice mathematic.
Thank you. Well, cards like Bash also are okay, because you can piece it together with Fire War Axe to remove stuff. But Recful is taking it so slow. It's literally like a net zero difference. Let's start taking bets. How high do you think Recful's life will get this game? Maximum.
Oh, yeah. Who's the closest wins?
Yeah, like Price is Right style.
I say 70.
70? He's at 71!
70 armor.
Oh, 70 armor.
I mean, that's all that matters, right?
I was like, Gaara, that's some really bad betting.
Yeah, no, 70 armor.
So you can, he thinks he can get to 100 health.
He can't break through a Vortex World record of 72.
What do you think? I saw 76 the other day. What do you think, Eloise? How much? Wow, he slams his own slime, so he can play around Brawl.
It depends on if he wants to play more aggressively. I think he can. Because he's got a taunt. He won't lose any armor from now on.
What's the answer? What's the answer? Final answer. Rope is burning.
What do you say, Frozen?
Are you doing a bet?
Yeah.
What's the point?
The loser, the person who's the farthest away, difference-wise, gets hit by pillow from each other person on the couch.
Okay, then what do you bet?
I bet that he'll reach 105.
What?
Total life.
105?
Yeah.
Well, then what is the 5?
That's 5 over 100. So he'll have 100 plus 5.
75 armor.
Oh, you mean 90 armor plus 15 health?
No, just in general. What's the highest life total will you achieve?
Okay. Then 106?
Wow. You are the worst type of human.
What?
I hope it's like 103, and then me and Gara get to like.
I think that's actually a pretty good time to make like a giveaway. You know, before a Warrior Mirror starts.
Yeah.
People can like bet who will reach the highest armor count, and then you can win a Need for Speed chair.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like you will end up like 70 or 60 armor.
What? Stop in the 90s? No way. Let's dream big, boys. Oh. And girl. Well, he didn't. Now was like a time to brawl kind of yourself, but this is exactly what I was talking about. Playing Boom into minions actually kind of gives Brawl some anti-value in a way. So it does complicate things.
But Brawl is like one out of three chance.
Yeah.
And this is like.
Which is pretty good to do something. Oh god, we almost already hit the end of the deck. That's crazy.
Whoa.
He's
pretty quick.
Yeah, he doesn't have a lot of cards. Like a lot of big threats.
He cycles really fast. We're already at the beginning of the end, guys. Although we still have about, you know, 7 or 8 more turns, realistically.
How many has Rekfer? Probably 2 cards, yeah.
Wow, I didn't realize Dan Sivka had such a was so light on the threats.
So he's 1 turn up in fatigue. It's a big deal. So his last card should be Alex Strasza?
Yeah.
He haven't got a lot of armor.
Last card is Alex Strasza, yeah, it could be. Oh
okay.
Man.
Rekfer is winning the race even with just 2 power on both.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rekfer keep on hitting with the Belcher.
Oh no, he doesn't
play.
Oh,
he has a second brawl.
That's really
so bad.
That's
so
really
bad for the mirror.
That's really bad.
Oh my goodness.
But he's double BGH.
I'm out of cards.
Stasifka's got a lot of dead card, like double brawl, double BGH.
Second BGH is
double
somewhat
slam,
relevant.
Double slam.
I mean, BGH in a way is relevant because it can either kill Grommash and lets him use Execute.
Yeah.
Or it's just a minion to attack. So like, if you can have something stick onto the board, that BGH negates the tank up and gets him some damage. But then the ultimate question is, do you wait for your opponent's shields to evaporate and then start being aggressive, or do you be aggressive now? Because when you, for example, when you see Sylvanas...
We all lost.
Our production team is so troll. Sylvanas, if you have Sylvanas and your opponent's at fatigue, you actually should wait till he has 0 armor to play Sylvanas, because then they can't shield slam Sylvanas or like steal with their Sylvanas, etc.
Rekfer is a genius, man. If he wins it to control mirror to fatigue against them,
dude. He's got such a better deck to do it, too.
Just up.
He's at 90. 90. Oh, sorry. He's going to be at 92?
He can still armor up.
I said
70. I'm going to win, man. It's pretty good.
Actually, if it goes above that,
he will not go above that.
Yeah.
He's taking 15 damage. Come on.
Are you kidding me? He's got Armorsmith out, and he's still going to get 4 armor per turn.
It will be damn close.
But it's actually good if it stays at this, because she bet the highest number. And we bet the 2 lowest numbers,
yeah,
so we'll win based off proximity.
No, you don't win.
No, we both win. The loser, which is you.
No.
Both in the.
You are a loser too. Come on, I know English better than
outside
you.
Outside of Hearthstone, I am a loser, but in Hearthstone right now, and this tournament
Gera
specifically,
is
the winner.
And this we casting,
are
both loser.
You are no.
Yes.
No.
She knows what's up. I'm the winner.
He's afraid to play Shield Maiden because he just doesn't want to let him get value off the weapon. He's like, you should kill this Armorsmith with the weapon first. In some ways, it's like...
67? Pretty close, man.
67.
Wait,
oh,
he might
man.
Actually reach exactly... No, he will not reach exactly 17.
Here's another problem. Rekfer doesn't have an activator for Grommash. So Grommash can't actually do like a 10 damage thing. So
all brawls will be useless.
It might be better to just like Grom the Shield Maiden now.
I think
actually,
4 damage is very good.
I think you play Acolyte Brawl or something like that.
Or actually, you're a good point. Grom just without just
yeah,
a 4 damage.
You're not injured.
You will never get value of Brawl again.
Yeah, that's a good point. He's never going to have more than 2 minions. This might be the brawl turn.
And then Stan's, well, he doesn't know that Stan has second brawl. But when do you want to brawl? It's like a dead card. You want to use all your cards except the shield blocks, obviously.
That's true.
The shield blocks at this stage are just basically death cards. Unless they can keep you alive for one turn, which it won't happen, because this fatigue stage will literally go to like 8 per turn, 9 per turn, 10 per turn.
And his Sylvanas will like win him the game. He can like shield slam his own Sylvanas for like another 12 turns or something.
Yeah, but Sylvanas is also a minion, and I don't think you really want to do
oh,
that.
Oh, he's here to gamble, man.
No, I think he's going to kill and use this as removal. I think this is okay as well, because in the end, you have Sylvanas as the final say, and you can steal his Grommash. He's going to Big Game Hunter, then you Brawl, then you're stuck on Acolyte or Grommash, and that's checkmate. Wreckful should win.
Miss Lethal?
Shield slam the face, of course. Except, here's the really funny thing, even if he shield slammed face, he wouldn't kill him. With 60 damage of a shield slam to the face, like say this was a Wrath Guard instead of a Big Game Hunter, he still wouldn't win.
That's pretty cute.
That is Control Warrior in a nutshell.
Oh, sounds very interesting.
Brawl. It's time to Brawl, Wreckful. If you feel really ambitious, you can play your Acolyte in Brawl, but just Brawl. Just do it. You got this.
Yes.
Yeah, Acolyte doesn't... You don't want to win.
Well, you do and you don't, because like you want to deal with these minions before Sylvanas comes out.
Is it worth to get one draw closer to Fatigue to kill two minions?
Well, how would it draw? Like Grom would be the only way to get it one closer.
Yeah,
yeah, that's fine. Because then you shield slam or you shield slam the Grom and play Sylvanas.
No, you steal Grom.
You steal Grom?
I don't know. No, you kill Grom and play Sylvanas, so he has to kill Sylvanas.
Sylvanas as a final board play is okay, because even doing 5 damage per turn is really big, because you're taking even fatigue damage.
But you're also dealing like 10 damage to your opponent with the
Grom.
Just has to do the maths.
This is a lot of math counting. This is, actually,
but
this
Wreckful is really good at it. If he tries, I think he's really good at it.
If he tries,
but he has
pen and paper, and he's definitely not like singing and dancing and laughing right now.
And I think the main reason was that Stan had no really big threats. He had no Ysera, right?
Yeah, no Ysera.
No Alexstrasza.
No Alexstrasza.
You haven't seen Execute yet, so he doesn't want the Grommash to be injured.
Okay, well, Wreckful doesn't have to do much. He can just pass. He's still ahead in life. And that 12 difference is a pretty big deal.
Okay, now it's very interesting. They all have, like, plenty of removal left. Wow, this is actually very interesting now.
This is, like, the end of Control Warrior matchups are always really funny.
No, he has to just play as Sylvanas and win. He can't enable Execute.
If he's been keeping track, then he knows there's no more shield slams left.
Yeah.
So Sylvanas is fine to play. But then what happens when he plays Acolyte? You just shield slam it then?
Oh, he might. Oh, he will just play Acolyte Brawl.
Ah, you're right. Ah, that's right. Acolyte gives a chance to Brawl.
I mean, we're all here to gamble at this point. So just go for the Sylvanas.
No, I think, why not just pass? The onus is on your opponent to actually take the initiative here.
I think armor pass is the good play. Good play.
Yeah.
But now he's one up in fatigue, right?
Because of the draw. So Wreckful is now ahead by one. Wreckful just took 5, so Stan's just take 5 here too.
But he's up in armor.
First part of the game, Wreckful keeps on hitting Stasivka's face with a Belcher.
Yeah.
Like 4 damage every turn, 4 damage every turn.
Yeah, so that was pretty relevant.
Stasivka haven't got much armor to play the late game.
I mean, at some point you have to play the Sylvanas, because both players will just not do anything.
Oh man, both these guys are writing down so much. They're doing like factorials and binomials and algebraic linear expressions, and they're like, what is going on?
This is epic no matter what. No matter how much resident sleepers in the chat, this is epic.
No, exactly. It's like people talk about Hearthstone doesn't require like actually thinking and stuff. This is not true. Look at this. There's so much planning involved.
Can we break?
Oh, really? You think so?
Can we break the fatigue?
Is there any choice? I mean, is there any play in the last 4 turns? Any other place?
Yeah, he can definitely mess up by being too hasty and not patient enough.
Oh.
And also, the way things lined up to this point, like, The way he threw away his Jacera, he could have an extra Emerald Drake, extra
so
Laughing
funny.
Yes,
it's
yes.
So,
funny
so many. Both calculating.
Yeah, so many strategies, and but what we see is that the last five turns just armor up.
Well, because all the decisions that led up to this is what created this. Like, because Wreckful gave away his Jacera. Like, Wreckful had the greedier deck. He should win.
Yes.
I think Wreckful is winning, though. He can't enable Grommash. Because of the 4 damage as well, he's trying to, like... Stan is up in fatigue, and he has the additional 4 burst damage.
But the up in fatigue will only matter if it's a difference of, like, 15 damage or 16 damage, I think. Which we might get to.
He doesn't even need to do anything.
Yeah, he can just armor up.
I heard that, like, after 20 turn or 25 turn, the game will end itself.
True that. Yeah. It will end at something like turn 50 each.
This game will end in half an hour, right?
Well, here's another thing, excited. Too. I think Stan Sifko is realizing that armor will be dissipating soon, and that he can wait so that Shield Slam is not relevant. And then, this is what I was talking about. You just keep fatigue going up until the point where you can't even really Shield Slam, even if you have it. So that way, it's one less removal spot, and you can't Shield Slam your own Sylvanas to steal it.
Yes.
And then it'll come down to a brawl. Most likely that's what's going to be happening here. 9 damage. It's going to go to like 12 to 13, 14 damage fatigue.
How many bananas did he eat during this match? Someone keep count.
About as many insightful things Eloise had to say about Warrior vs. Warrior.
Burn.
You're just complaining the entire time. You're just like,
oh, really?
Hey, can we move on to the next game?
But am I doing the right thing? That's just arming up. Yeah. I'm only being honest. What's wrong with this world?
I like how they're roping your return. That really makes it more intense.
It is because Stan Sifko is trying to calculate, like, I think in how many turns. Because they're technically not on... Like, if you look at it as like, armor negates the fatigue turn, they're technically on, like, 5 fatigue instead of 9 fatigue. So, you kind of negate that. But he's thinking about, like, what turn will the fatigue shred the armor, and is that the turn I can play Grommash?
You know what's funny? They do it at the same time. They both did the mass, and then...
they both paused at the same time.
They both didn't change their play. So now they're doing the math again, because one is wrong. One of them is wrong.
This is the only correct play.
One of them has to be wrong, because nobody's changing anything.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think Stan Sifko is the right one here. Like, based off his hand, he's playing to what he can do, but I think Wreckful still has the final say. I mean, one of the things, we're eyeballing it, we're not actually calculating it out, but...
They both did the very correct play every
Stop hating! Stan Sifko's playing to his only way to win, which is hoping that Wreckful makes a mistake of just timing Sylvanas, and then he can get value with Acolyte Brawl, win the Brawl, and then Grommash for the win. He can win that way.
Yeah. Make very sense. Exactly.
I think it's kind of cool. I think Stan Sifko's playing with what he's naturally very unfavored in this matchup, because he's playing an Owl and 2 Brawls, like, that's just not
very good. It's actually very sick. If he wins the Brawl, he will steal the Acolyte, and then he can get another draw from the
You're right! He steals the Acolyte!
Whoa!
That is so sick!
Garou, you're so smart! Oh!
Yeah, I just didn't want to, like, interrupt you guys. You're so funny. Kappa.
Kappa?
Gara's not amused. So that'll be... Let's see, next turn he takes 12, he goes 31. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I think that's 4 turns. 4 turns he can play Grommash, or maybe 5. 11, 12, 13 is 25, 38, 42 damage of fatigue, but he gains 20 life.
Wow, so complicated.
So, he'll be at 5 armor. Yeah, I think in 5 turns you can play Grommash. Maybe. Yeah. Maybe.
Good story, bro.
You mean 20 turns?
Five and a half turns, six turns, I think.
Oh, five and a half turns.
I think that's where we are.
Okay.
there's still, I think Wreckville is now realizing what Stan Sifu is doing, or he probably realized a while ago, but starting to like really count down the final moments of when he can play Sylvanas, or should he ever play Sylvanas. Also, here's like a really amusing thing. If Wreckful truly, what's up?
Yeah, he can shell block and shell slam his Sylvanas.
No, he can't.
He can do it in one turn.
No, he can't. Because you draw off the fatigue.
Sorry.
And any armor you gain immediately shaves off.
Okay.
But what's really funny is that he can armor up to 4 and shield slam for 4. So there is still a possibility of like, if like Grom hits Sylvanas or something like that, like Grom would have 4 health remaining. So like he, if there was some kind of weird mess up where they actually bumped and traded and then brawled and lost, then he could armor up shield slam Grom for 4 and still kill it if he needed to, but he still has executes. I'm not sure. I'm just talking out of my butt.
What?
I'm just saying, like, I'm just trying to find interesting points to talk about while we wind down the game.
Yeah, another funny thing would be if the chat would go control V plus enter and not cheat.
Yeah. This game is hurting my brain, man. All right, so we finally reached that point of fatigue basically negating. It'll shred their last remaining armor here on the following turn. And now Stan Sifka has a choice of playing Grom. Just does not. And he's running out of time because in 3 turns or 4 turns, he'll die himself. Mm. Well, we did it. We got back to full health.
I killed the chat.
Is there ever I really wonder if
he
there's...
He's for life.
Yeah. I really wonder if there's ever going to be a build of Warrior that just literally is a draw Warrior. Like, it just makes you draw because you both die from hitting turn 50 each or something like that.
The best part is it will come down to the Acolyte 50-50 and we are just waiting for
it. Yeah, we're waiting for the inevitable.
Many turns we're waiting for it.
Well, Stan Sifka.
I wonder, this is what it is.
He's very hungry.
I think Wreckful doesn't know that Stan Sifka doesn't have Alex Strauss.
He has superpowers now.
I think Wreckful still thinks that Stan Sifka has Alex.
I think, yeah.
So
yeah.
I think that's what he's really worried about.
I think he knows the Grommash thing.
He knows Grommash
thing.
So he chooses to play the Sylvanas.
Baby.
And this is what we're talking about. The Acolyte
Time
Brawl
to gamba.
Is what's going to happen. And
time to gamba.
Yeah. Here we go. He wants him to steal the Acolyte. Acolyte must win. No!
Oh!
Wait a second. Is that still enough, though? He's dead in 2 turns.
But he makes him draw an additional one.
Yeah. Oh.
Dude.
Well, but
I think Stan Sifka just won.
But wait.
Dude. Is he,
yeah.
Wait. He survives.
Oh, yeah.
He survives. Right. This is 15 damage. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Sifka, you are a goddamn G.
It's 50%. It was 50%.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, that's so sick.
How did you not get hyped over that game? You are so good, Sifka. Oh my gosh, Wreckful just wants to concede right now. He's like, all right, I give up.
He's out. He's conceding the series.
What a god! What a god!
He's playing Sylvanas, his only prize.
Can we have a camera?
What if he...
Yeah. Or if you don't lose the
Lucera.
Yeah, 50%. If you don't lose the Lucera either.
It was just gamba, Wreckful. Just gamba.
Oh my god.
They both left the room.
are you done?
is
that the series?
Oh man, what the fuck is happening?
Oh my god.
How did
you not get hyped over that? That was so sick.
That was pretty sick, yeah.
I told you, man.
It came down to 50-50. I knew it.
And Alex was like, it was Arbor up.
But
that was so sick. Oh my god, I can't get over it.
He cannot play Sylvanas. What if he don't play Sylvanas? What, can he win?
That's a good question.
He can win. If he
just literally passed the entire time. No, I think Grom would just hit him and then be the difference
that's
maker.
That's 4 damage. But it's one turn.
If he plays Grommash and hits the face, what does he do? He can't actually kill. Oh, he has to armor up, shield slam, execute. You're right, actually. Maybe you're right. I don't know. There's a lot of what ifs.
Yeah, when he plays Sylvanas, I was like, what? Why?
What if he doesn't play Sylvanas?
I just asked this question like
Hey, I believe. Hold on. I believe the armor count got to about 96 or something around there,
Kappa.
Which means Gaara and I win, which means we both owe Eloise a
hit with
Polo.
What? But I am proved to be the smartest.
You are the loser, too.
Yeah, well, that's not what the bet... Stop. Ow. Not the hair. Come on.
There's one rule in fighting with Frodan. It's not the hair.
Where's Rick from? Where did he go?
I think he needed a bathroom break.
Yeah.
Eloise told me one time that there's a famous nickname for these kinds of warriors.
Oh, yeah.
What is it called?
Yeah, in China, it's called... You want to say it. Wow, it's so rude for me to say that.
We should do comedy routines together because we set up the punchlines really well.
Why do we have to be so rude?
She said that that in China they call control warriors hold your pee warriors.
Yes.
Because it's not a battle of who's smarter or who's better or you know whoever's the better deck, but it's literally who can hold their urine. The longest because of how the length of the match.
Yeah, and with Reno Jackson.
With Reno Jackson, it even got worse. With Fatigue Warrior. Oh my God.
I've seen people posting their Reno Jackson games on Twitter, on Reddit, where they replayed it like 5 times with duplicates. It's good, man.
Yeah. That game was awesome. All right. I mean, it took a little bit of build up there. There was definitely some. Like, you know, slow moments, but the payoff was so sick.
Well,
My God.
I think Rockful probably won't expect that play when he plays Sylvanas. I think he probably about Sylvanas is guaranteed good play.
Also, I still think that he was worried about Alexstrasza as a threat because I don't really put...
Yeah, I think
I don't
he's
really put
thinking
Rockful
about
on the type to know
Alexstrasza and Grommash. He has to remove two of them big threats.
Right, so that's what he probably thought, and then he got baited.
We were on, like... 15 fatigue, right? And it's like, after 5 turns, the game will end itself, right?
Yeah.
Wow, it's so exciting!
Yeah, it was a really exciting finish. To the point where I think Stan Sivka literally broke Rekful. Like, he's just, I don't even know where he is. I think he's probably in the bathroom still vomiting from how disgusted he is about how that game went. But to be fair, there was lots of things that Rekful could have done to win that game.
Yeah.
A lot of things.
He eventually can't play as expected, 50%.
Yeah. Like turn 5, he can call out a Justicar instead of Shell Maiden. That probably will be much better.
Actually, you know, maybe he missed a few turns of armoring.
Yeah, he missed at least 5 turns, I think.
He also used like some weapon, like some removal pieces a little bit carelessly. He lost the Ysera. I mean, Sivka also didn't play optimally either. Like, he could have not used shield blocks and been way less behind in the fatigue.
Exactly.
He would have been just as fine. So,
he got
like,
really unlucky on Ysera already, and he got really unlucky on Sylvanas. if he get luckier on Ysera, he already win this game like 30 minutes ago.
You know what's the really hilarious thing? Rekful ended the game with Shield Slam and 2 executes.
Yeah,
so he only
insane.
Used 1 Shield Slam the entire game, which was on the Sylvanas that was, which was on the Ysera that was stolen.
Yeah.
And he didn't end up using any removal. Like, that's how much his deck had more threats than what his opponent did.
He didn't have 2 cruel tests in his deck.
Yeah, were you waiting for Alexstrasza too?
No, I was.
Because he doesn't have Alexstrasza.
He kills me first if he has cruel task number 2 and if Grom.
Right.
So I thought he had cruel task number 2, but he only runs 1, I guess.
Yeah, and he didn't have
I think I was writing it down, but I didn't go full tryhard. I didn't. He only had 1.
You weren't documenting everything.
He has 2 crew tasks, yes, but he only used.
That's like. And if I was tryharding and writing it down harder.
Uh oh. So you did know about the Alexstrasza, the lack of Alexstrasza.
The series is not over.
You did know that there's a lack of Alexstrasza, right?
No, I didn't. I didn't know. I actually thought the last.
I thought
there's execute, right?
Can we have some PJs?
There's execute, acolyte.
I didn't know it was brawl or whatever.
Yeah.
And
can we get some PJs?
I thought it might be Alex. Yeah. No, but I thought there was cruel task Grom.
All right. Anyways, get your ass back there.
This is next level baby rage.
You gotta play.
This is next level baby rage. Jesus, can you just play your goddamn game, man?
Yeah. He's done, man. He's gonna lose.
Yeah, like.
No, the rest of Stasivka's deck are very hard to counter. Druid. Like he's got Handlock. He's got another. He's got Handlock and Warrior, which is Druid very favored.
Yeah, I guess
so. Druid, Rekful can do it with Druid.
He can do it with Druid.
Yeah.
It would be pretty epic if it ended up being like something like that.
Now we see some like turn 2 Wild Growth into Innervate, Lore Tap stuff, and he just wins in like 4 or 5
He's just like cheeses with Innervate combo. All right, well, We got to go to game number two. I don't even know what lineups they have anymore. All I know is Sansifka is a boss.
Yeah, that was...
I think he's so lucky. Rockfall is just unlucky. Rockfall is a boss, too.
Wow.
Are you a member of Temple Storm? Come on.
You're such a homer.
Why Reyna sent you here?
Good casting 101, Eloise. Just be as unbiased as possible. And plus, you have to appreciate that was a really cool game. Really cool game. Really cool.
Yes.
Game. Okay. All right. Well, we're just gonna wait for the game to start then.
What are we exactly here waiting for?
We're waiting for Rekful to make a choice because Sivka is staying on Warrior. He has no choice. And now it's all about what Rekful wants to do.
No brainer to go Druid.
Go Druid, yeah.
Yes.
He's thinking very hard. Look at him. He's like,
Dude, he's done.
Oh, I must think hard.
We should have a rope for...
This shampoo is so good.
I don't know even... What's his other deck? His other deck is Hunter, right? Because his Paladin was banned.
Yeah, mid-range.
Oh, Freeze Mage, Handlock, and...
No, I'm talking about Rockfall.
Because
he's the one making the choice here.
Yeah, Druid is the correct play. So generally, I think Rockfall can wreck Stasifka's rest of the class with Druid. Handlock, yeah. Freeze Mage, and... yes.
So just draw White Growth and Innervate.
Yeah, as well as minions to play. Sometimes you get Wild Growth, Innervate, Aspirant, and nothing else. Just like
draw
those.
Wild Growth and Shade into Shredder, into Claw.
Here's some interesting questions. You have Taskmaster and Execute. Sometimes I want to keep those against Druid.
Yeah, Execute is...
You can keep one Execute, but normally you are looking for weapon.
I push really hard for weapons, but...
Yeah, I would mulligan everything for a weapon because you go first. You can only mulligan three cards.
Yeah.
Maybe I would get rid of the Execute.
Or even just Death Spy is really good.
But if it is me, I would rather wait for Rekful to mulligan first to see if he's got chance to play to keep Innervate or something so that I can decide whether if I keep Execute.
Oh, Rekful didn't mulligan!
Oh my
Are
god!
Are you serious, dude? Dude, no, you fucked up, man. Oh, excuse my language. You messed up.
Rekful, stand up again. What
dude,
is
you
it?
Dude, you can't take that back.
What is it?
He's so tilted, he didn't mulligan, and he kept a very bad opening hand.
Like,
oh
what
God.
Happened? Okay, here, let's give him the headset again.
Is there any kind of rule of this?
What happened?
I don't know, man. I don't know.
He just wants
only with Rekful. Only with Rekful. I don't know what's happening, man.
Froda, why are you rigging the tournament again? Why? What did you do? What have you done to the tournament?
Rekful has left the building.
I didn't realize it was mulligan. I don't know. I was spaced out. I'm gonna stop. I'm just gonna let him have it.
All right. Rekful says he wants to concede the match.
I was thinking about the last game and how I could have just won, and then I didn't realize the mulligan was ending.
Just play.
And then I just want to concede and do a I'll play next one. I wish I just took the time and did all the math the last game. I'm sad.
Feels bad, man. Feels bad. We all wish you did. All right. Well,
he likes the challenge. He wants to go 0-1.
He does.
He likes the challenge.
And I guess Sivka is our winner. Come over, man. Congratulations.
I didn't expect that.
Yeah.
Come sit on the couch.
Okay. Here.
So.
I have no clue what happened. So.
All right. Well, basically, he didn't mulligan, and he kept a very bad opening hand of Azure Drake and Druid of the Claw.
He was thinking about the previous game, and he forgot it was mulligan, and he had a really terrible.
Yeah.
Game.
Dude, you literally tilted the guy to a victory. How sick is that? You're a boss, man.
Yeah.
Well played, man.
Handlock win another game.
Wow. Yeah, it was a cool game, but... Yeah.
Do you not feel out of honor winning that way? Is that what it is?
I don't like winning that way.
Yeah, I don't think anyone does.
Like,
really.
I think everyone is looking for a great series, and it's kind of unfortunate.
Well, it started off great.
It started off great. Like, we can do a remake like of the game. Like, I don't mind. Like, if he forgot to mulligan, we can... replay the game, like, I'm completely fine with it, like, if Rekful is for, like...
I think he just doesn't want to play. I think right now he's just... He is PO'd.
He's already sitting at the poker table. He's already sitting at the poker table.
Well, not only that, but he's laying back like he's reclining in a hospital bed, saying his last words to Dennis and Oskaka.
Like, yeah, I'm here to play Hearthstone, not to, like, to, you
know. Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, whatever.
All right, well, let's at least talk about that Control Warrior game. Your deck is wildly unfavored against this.
Yeah, it's true, because, like, I have all the card draw spells, and the game goes to Fetic most of the time, so it's like 10% for me or something like this in this mirror match. So yeah, it's kind of difficult to win, but if something goes well together, you
Like stealing your Sarah?
Yeah, it's most like about drawing Justicar first, which I didn't achieve, but I somehow also...
Are you cool with the rematch? Like, you can mulligan and we can play the game, actually.
Wow, what a guy.
Yeah, last time when I played against Sivka in another game, in another match, I got disconnected. So and Sivka just told me that, if you want to rematch, we can do it. And then we did another match. It was
what a guy.
Faith in humanity restored.
That's right.
Yeah. Humanity restored.
Sivka.
What a god.
Sivka is literally Reno Jackson.
What a god.
Just restoring all of our faith in humanity.
Yeah, we can play out the match. Like, it's completely fine. Let's
stand
do it.
Stand the man.
Oh my fucking god. That's like.
Wow.
Whoa.
That was the best winner's interview ever.
Stan Sivka, you are my spirit animal.
That is so cool.
You, man.
That is
you.
I don't know what to say.
Damn. Well, I really thought that was going to be like a disastrous case of drama, but Stan Sivka literally saved it, man.
That is like the longest cast ever as well.
Yeah,
that was just game one.
We get to be part of it.
It's like one
this has been immortalized in internet history. You get to be part of it, so make sure you make your words count.
Oh.
Wow.
Less than three all the way.
Well, you know what? A lot of people left the stream thinking the series was over because they were like, oh, I guess that's over. But we just got done with game one, you guys. And if anything was indication of the past hour and a half, I am really excited to see the remainder of the series.
And we should say that Stan Sivka's rest of the class is not very favored against Wreckful, and he's still making this decision.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. Yeah, I mean, he's also got balls, because I think maybe he's feeling confident because he lost a matchup he really shouldn't have won. Based off the Control Warrior mirrors. So he's just like, yeah, you know, why not Mulligan? Maybe I can beat him anyways.
Also, like, winning like this doesn't feel good, you know? He would feel bad about
it. It's true. Like, I wouldn't want to win. Like, if I won like this over Tice or something, I'd be like, no, I want to play a real match. I don't care if it's like for just a little bit of money here. It's definitely like for some of these players, especially for like guys like, you know, Sivka, for Tice, they play because they want to be the best. You know, they want to have the glory. It's not really about the prize money or something. All right. Okay. So
we got here.
Game
but this
two.
Whole event, was so epic. What happened? Like both standing up, talking about the maps, and then rage quitting the game, and then replaying the game,
and then rage quitting
after the winners interview,
and then missing the mulligan. Like who? No one really. We never really seen someone like legitimately miss the mulligan
because he was thinking about the previous game and first jumping out and talking to everyone about the game.
Yeah. What did I tell you, man? He's missing the pills.
What just happened?
But if you ever watch the ending of Limitless, apparently it's a happy ending. So maybe things aren't so well for Sivka.
Mm-hmm. And judging from this hand, he's got no weapon.
He has no weapon, but he still has ways to deal with threats early on. He's got Execute for any big Innervate play. And I think that's really big. Plus, even having like this 1-1 is really cool because you get to challenge something for 4 mana and then maybe execute it. If it gets innervated out or something.
Okay, choices. Gentlemen, choices. What to play?
Shade
is fine.
Shade is fine, yeah. Darnest Sashman doesn't really help you ramp anything. And
you
want more meaningful minions.
You also
want
to get it out as soon as possible.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Warrior can't do anything about it.
He can. He can brawl. He also can cleave Gaara. Believe it or not, that is a card that used to be played once upon a time.
Yeah. And the previous game went to Fatigue.
It was against Undertaker. Do you remember? People put Cleave and Warrior to kill Undertaker.
Yeah, good times.
It was like turn one Undertaker, Cleave.
Bad times for me because I played Undertaker.
That's right. Gaara was a Hunter player.
No, they had to kill my Undertaker with BGH.
That is the direct counter. The hard counter, so to speak.
Oh, he has the brawl. That's pretty good.
That's huge. In fact, he should use it now, right?
Yeah, if the Keeper survives, that's damn good. It's like insane.
He's got double brawl. He can use one.
He can get away with Slam, Execute, and Fiery War Axe, though, and doesn't have to brawl.
Mm-hmm. But like, the board is also not very strong.
Also, if he doesn't remove anything, then Rekful doesn't have to play anything. The board is strong
you're
enough.
Right.
He doesn't,
All right, brawl it is.
So basically, you're forced to execute.
I don't think he can get a better brawl.
Oh my god.
That's, wow.
That is so
justice.
Good.
Justice.
That is karma.
That is justice.
That is karma.
Shredder placement.
And there it is. But I mean, Druid is still pretty dominant position if it can continue to solidify the board. However, that's a lot of cards and removal pieces for Sifka.
Rekful, again, is looking for someone to talk to, looks like.
Yeah. He looks like he's kind of streaming right now. But I think he's talking to an admin, maybe. He's looking at me like shaking his head.
I don't know.
I'm not going to assign him anything.
I don't know. What does he want?
Oh, I like this little icon we have of a warrior, by the way. That armor cracking. It conveniently looks like a logo of a team that I know.
You know, in Chinese community, we talk about that if you can break a warrior's armor, you already win this game. You don't have to kill him now. You already proved that you win this game.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe because of the brawl RNG or something. I don't know.
Well, Ancient Lore, one of the more problematic cards, but you have Death Spy set up. Oh,
double
two lores.
Feels pretty damn good, man.
That's really good for Druid. We'll see if it ends up being the reason he wins here. He might not need it, depending on what he draws.
Maybe he will have some very good Shredder RNG. Like Doomsday or something.
Sifka? Yeah, that is a possibility. Some small 2-drop comes out here. And that could be a big way to come back.
Rekful's draws were really good. Azudrake is also really good.
All right.
Execute.
Reasonable minion comes out. You can execute in Shield Maiden. Or would you develop Sylvanas preemptively?
Probably. Like, your opponent played already one Shredder.
Yeah.
If he swipes Sylvanas to clear it effectively,
yeah.
To have like a 4-mana place,
yeah.
Kind of likely.
You do
don't
want
a keeper. You can only play the one remaining Shredder of the deck that's like next level.
Okay. Well, he does have Force Nature's Average Drawer.
He could also just swipe.
Yeah. Swipe. Swipe puts him down to...
I kind of want to
18, 16.
Yeah, you draw cards.
Drawing
cards is always good.
Because if he swipe, he cannot do anything this turn.
Well, he sets up for lethal next turn, technically.
He can spell power swipe.
But if he draw cards, he still have lethal, probably.
Yeah. No, it's true. I'm just saying. But if he swipes, he's technically still sets up for lethal. Mm-hmm.
And he has a Zodrake swipe next turn, guaranteed.
Wow.
If he wants to.
Not a bad Emperor Thoris in hand at all. Let's see here. So many fancy plays that allow him to get back in.
Like shield block, draw cards, shield slam, play the weapon, protect your maiden.
Yeah.
Having just one big minion on board is usually enough against Druid. Except they play Dr. Doom.
Oh, man.
Oh, now that's, even Dr.
Whoa.
Doom is
that's a great
You can crew task. Oh.
BGH?
Yeah. You should say that, Froden.
No, you're
you made this play.
Yeah, it's better.
It's really powerful for tempo on board.
Yeah, against Druid, every single minion, like even if it's a small minion, it's a big deal. Because Druid is very bad at board clearing, but he has the spell power swipe.
Oh, you're right. The spell power swipe is so
I mentioned it like 2 times.
Oh, gosh. You did mention it twice, Gaara.
Yeah, I did, actually.
I'm affirming your feelings.
That's okay.
Spell power swipe is really big because, again, initiative has been taken away from the warrior player.
But he cannot get rid of the armor, so you can still on shield slam.
Yeah, shield slam and Dr. Boom.
Oh, that is very strong.
That's really strong. He doesn't have the BGH currently as well.
But the problem is that Drake's got so many cards.
Yeah.
And with the Emperor, it's so scary.
And he will draw more cards with the Zudrake.
What's so funny is...
there's really nothing to think about, by the way, about this turn. It's very obvious.
What's so funny is that the opposite is also true, too, where it's like Druid was in a position where they didn't have many cards, and Warrior had a lot of cards, and Warrior was struggling. Now Druid has a lot of cards, and Warrior has no cards, and they're struggling, too. It's like, this matchup's just tough. Shield Slam Arena. Let's do it. Dr. Boom, can you bring it back?
Yeah, Dr. Boom is pretty sick.
Innervate
is also pretty sick.
So, I mean, there is a really good Emperor hand.
He could war and charge face with claw and then combo next turn, something like that.
And he can also Emperor and charge face this turn.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's set up next turn lethal.
Yeah.
He can play aggressively. I don't think he will play Ancient of War.
No. No, you will definitely play something aggressive. You might even play Shade, but you don't want to die to
Shade.
Boobot.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. That's like, definitely want to set up Lethal for next turn.
Yeah.
What I want is Reckful to play it in Uproot mode. Just go full tilt. Just uproot your Ancient of War.
You could like swipe face, then Druid of the Claw face, and then innovate out the Shade. Set up Lethal that way as well.
Yes.
And your Shade doesn't die to...
To the Boombots.
Boombots.
Yep. Swipe Shade play is not too bad, I think. It uses 12 mana pretty efficiently.
And you get the Shade out. The thing about, like, when your Shade sits in your hand, it gets worse and worse over time. I don't like that too much, because the chance that Shade dies is very high.
Oh, he's going to use Innervate for Sneaky Lethal, probably. Mm-hmm.
Sneaky Lethal.
He will miss some damage,
He misses a lot of damage to the cluster.
Yeah. Well, he's going to probably use Druid of the Claw and then Force Nature Savage Roar, which gives him...
And I think this probably be Druid's best chance.
Yeah.
If he lost this chance, then it will be meant for
the
cluster.
You're right.
If the Shade dies, he's
Sludge Belcher.
Whoa.
Sludge Belcher is such a big deal, though.
Okay, he's not going for it. Yeah, Belcher is just too strong.
Oh my god.
Bothering with the Shade. Now he's having like a lot of counter pressure.
Yeah, you're right.
He'll get a lot of armor from this wipe.
Oh, Keeper! Oh. Keeper lets him combo. Oh, he can't.
It's 19 damage only. It's actually 1 damage off. I think he can even hero power. No, he can't. Because the Keeper is not good use. So what now?
You do want a Keeper though, right?
It was also a big mistake. He didn't go aggressive last turn. It was like too passive.
Would you? So can you Keeper and then play like Ancient of War and then be aggressive and like hit face with Shade?
If he very aggressive last turn, he still haven't got Lethal this turn
because
there's
Taunt
and Armorsmith. The Armorsmith is too.
But he had
disgusting.
Like a. He would have gotten rid of the Boombots, so he can't enable the Execute.
Mm-hmm.
Because he enabled the Execute with a Boombot.
But he can still trade the Emperor.
Yeah, but the problem now is now Rickfall Stanziska is aggressive. Like because he pushed 7 damage and it's a big difference. Now he has to be afraid of like some Grommash kill.
Oh, you're right. So he's playing defensive now. Oh, that's not a good. Oh no, he's gonna run out of time.
Oh no!
Oh
no! He's gonna be so salty. He's gonna be so salty.
No.
Oh god! Oh god!
Not again, Rickfall. Not again.
Oh, I think he finished.
Okay.
I think he finished.
Dude, he took a deep breath.
Don't be salty.
All right, you got it. He got it.
Oh,
got it. We made it, boys.
Oh,
and girl.
Because I was thinking that the innovate was still can use.
Right.
Yeah, so I think he made it.
Okay. Well, the Boomba survived. The lone survivor of that atrocity it witnessed.
He has to play the Sylvanas. Be more aggressive.
Oh man. Yeah, Sylvanas is definitely the right thing. And then you can set up a weapon. Do you feel aggressive enough to hit the face with the weapon? So you can set up with Grommash and Cruel Taskmaster.
Can I troll you?
Wow. Chat would also spam missed one damage.
No worries. We all have said something stupid on this cast. No worries.
I'm bad. I suck. I'm gonna retire after this because that was too much.
It's okay.
And we thought
at least you're not Reynad. At least you're not Reynad.
He's filling in the hole Reynad left. The complaining, the threat for retirement. Oh, a second combo.
I'm out.
Look at that.
I'm ranked 25.
All right. Do we uproot this? Let's uproot this. Let's go.
Uproot, all right.
Uproot. Do it.
Yeah, against a double BGH deck. I think it's... Let's gamble.
Who cares? You let's gamble. Cards. Do it.
It's time to gamble.
Come on, Rackful.
We are racing with two executes.
Uproot. Do it. Will he have lethal if he does... he will if he just keepers as well. Oh, come on. Still uproot. Do it.
Come on, it's time to gamble.
He's
thinking about it.
Oh!
Riot. Let's start a riot.
Wow. He doesn't play. He plays for himself only. Sifka wants to give fans a show. All right, well, it's only rightful that he draws Shield Slam off of this shield block to kill the Ancient of Lore.
Oh, just BGH. Anything.
Yeah, sure. BGH would be good, too.
Oh,
it's pretty damn good, bro.
Wow, that's a board clear.
Yeah, Rockfall has already seen this. He knows it will be a BGH
campaign. Oh, he's not happy. Oh, wait, he didn't
know. Oh, wait.
Oh, Sifka. All right, he played a little too fast.
Yeah, he's... Oh, now I'm right. He forgot to armor up. There you go.
He did forget to armor up. Nice. Yeah, wow, what a bad draw from Rockfall, too, the innervate. But you know what? Now, well, okay.
What do you think about this?
Interesting.
He will be wrecked, but...
Well, I guess he's playing around the death by killing it, and he won't have access to the 2-4, which is... it works out okay.
That was not good.
Wow, the Cruel Taskmaster is going to deal 6 damage to the face. So huge.
Plus trigger the Big Game Hunter. Pretty good value for 2 mana. I wonder if that armor will matter at all, by the way. Like, if it's like he loses by 1 or 2 HP.
But if he shows the Deathbite now, that's probably not good, you know? That's the thing.
Why?
But then he will not use his hero power to kill the Taskmaster, probably.
Yeah.
Then you hit face with the...
Yeah, if you hit face with the Deathbite, then he will probably use the Keeper to crit.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, then it's obvious because he knows...
This is too obvious.
Nah, do it.
Do it.
He already used an Ancient of Lore. He already used both two of the claws. He's used both Ancient of Lores. What else is he going to do?
Well, Sasivka is still doing mathematics on paper.
He's actually leaning forward, finishing his banana off stream. Oh, there it is.
Oh, how did you know?
Oh, I think he was just
judging from his
the chances
judging
of
from his gesture.
Higher.
Yeah.
You've got experience.
Yes, I'm very good with my left hand.
Nice innovates, bro.
All right, here we go. Grommash at the top. Let's go.
That's probably what he was calculating.
One time.
If it's more likely to draw Grommash or just kill him with the double death by charge.
That's pretty good. Sludge Belcher is a great draw. It answers perfectly. I wonder if Rifle's going to run out of cards soon. He's drawn with both lures. He's drawn with...
I mean, he said cycled. Early in the Venus interview, Kappa.
Wow, we are going to have...
he forces Dex to go to Fatigue. I mean, that's his strategy.
Wow. Wait, he drew another Wild Growth. Dude, he's so close. I'm betting he's at his last 3 or 4 cards.
Yeah,
right,
we will see the super big combo now.
Does Rackful even know what he has left in his
deck? Oh my god!
Oh!
Well, that's pretty damn good.
But Brawl!
Brawl coming!
You know this. You know the Belcher's gonna win that Brawl. You know that!
Actually, Rackful didn't see this. Oh, he saw the second Brawl, so he knows he has double Brawl.
If he don't play Dr. Bruma, he haven't got chance, I think. Warrior has so much attack.
Yeah, it's got 7 damage on board, like...
Yeah, he cannot kill the warrior in 2 turns if he doesn't play the Dr. Bloom.
Wow, force of nature. He's gonna ride the Shredder. He's gonna ride the Shredder all the way home.
But, like, all jokes aside, this is another epic game, by the way.
Dude, this is crazy, man. Each game of the series is so good.
Oh, he's going to use Innervate?
Oh, he's gonna hero power.
The Innervate is dead card.
Yeah, he's not gonna do anything with Innervate. It's fine. Trade it for a hero power.
That was actually a really good play by Rek for playing 1 second Brawl, even though he has only one card in hand.
Oh, such a good card.
Yeah, that's a terrible draw.
But can Rekfully, he, like...
Dude.
This guy's really upset. He didn't draw Justicar.
Nope.
And no Grommash.
Nope.
Right now. That's really unlucky.
I mean, yeah, more than the Justicar is the Grommash, because he would have won few turns over by now.
Yeah, the game, but also, like, this tank up strategy is much better with Justicar, obviously.
Right.
Where is the justice?
I think you can still play Armorsmith, right? Oh, it's just saving it for the Brawl. Oh, that's probably what he wants to do.
He probably wants to save the Armorsmith together with other minion to have some armor with the Deathbite. That's the correct way to use the Armorsmith.
Yeah, that's probably right, too. He's also calculating, like, what cards could Druid have, and Boom is one of them. What's another card that he could have? I think, like, a second Darnassus Aspirant? No, he already played both.
He played both.
Maybe second Shade.
He wants to set up a good board for Deathbite.
Yeah. Oh my god!
He will get so wrecked!
He's gonna get so wrecked!
Super wrecked!
Super wrecked!
Dude, unless Boom survives.
Oh my god.
Wait, what if Boom survives?
Oh god, he will get super wrecked.
Oh man.
And now he top decks Grommash, the most anticlimactic turn.
Do it!
Outcomes.
Wow.
He didn't even kill Armorsmith, that feels bad.
He doesn't need to brawl. He can actually just like
he really likes
armor up, shield slam, and whirl. Yeah.
He really likes to go for the Gamba play, man.
This is like the only time you brawl, right? Do you? Is there a world where you armor up, shield slam, and...
You know what's funny, though? Like, last turn, when he killed the Sludge Bursher, he played perfectly around second brawl, and now he plays absolutely into brawl.
Yeah.
That feels bad, though.
All right, well, if Dr. Boom survives, that's bad news.
I don't like that he didn't kill...
Oh! So this is the justice.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
No justice!
My greetings!
Oh my god!
She can still lose though.
No, he's got Savage Roar.
Oh, no.
That's it. It's over. Rekful has tied up the series.
She could disconnect.
No.
Oh, that's a good play. Disconnect.
Disconnect.
Wow. Rekful missed the BM. He could have B-game hunted his own Dr. Boom.
He could have conceded.
Well, Rekful think that Stensivka is a very good guy. He wants to be gentle.
Dude. This series is so Hearthstone. Oh my god. Oh man. You know what's funny too? I think Rekful also had one of the more memorable series before this match against Stensivka too, where he played he was playing in his previous group, and it was some plays too that just end up leading to some really funny scenarios and epic games.
This is the first game of the group, right?
This is the first game of the group. This is such a knee slapper, man. I'm enjoying this.
Imagine a rematch between Stensivka and Rekful.
Dude.
In like losers or something.
Oh, wow.
It doesn't get any better than this, guys. Druid versus the Handlock. Oh snap. I was getting comfortable. I was getting really comfortable.
And Wild Girls plus Emperor.
All right, I can make back now. Oh, God.
Wow. Crazy hand from both players.
Yeah, but I mean, Druid has... Druid has such an insane hand if he picks up an Ancient of Lore. If he picks up one more lore, like, the hand just becomes the nuts. All right, well, Wrath for one is still not bad if you want to cycle to just kind of stay alive.
The Emperor can at least survive for two turns.
That's just GG when that happens, especially when you reduce a Dr. Swag.
No, I mean, he's got Voidcaller, and there's no...
That's pretty good, but...
I mean, if he pulls out Jaraxxus, he can just answer minions for a long time with Defender of Argus.
He has to Wrath for one, right?
Yeah.
I think he know that there's something inside
the Voidcaller. You want to reduce combo really badly. He might draw a Shred as well, that would be absolute sick.
Oh yeah, if you draw Shredder, that'd be really nasty.
I'll draw a BGH. Have you seen BGH from his Druid deck?
Has he what?
BGH from Rekful's Druid deck.
Oh, it was in the very final moments of the game.
Yes, the last card.
He could have BGH.
Last card is the BGH.
Dr. Boom for BM. All right, well, he's also wondering if there's anything at the end of the Voidcaller. If so, can he deal with it? And the answer is not really.
He could draw a keeper.
No, he can. If he can, if
you have
Mal'Gan,
to draw.
If
you
Mal'Ganis comes out, then
he's thinking about Gamba again. Swipe it.
Oh man.
Maybe that's what comes out.
Stop it, Red
Bull. He's here to Gamba, man. Look, here to Gamba. I knew it.
Swipe. He's running out of time for him to respond to it. He better just hear power pass. Okay.
Yeah.
He better just do it. Don't tempt fate, man.
Oh, he's hilarious, man.
But
he's,
now
he's always here to Gamba. He's rubbing his hands, man.
Yeah.
He was here to Gamba.
Yeah, but now there's like, you know, some answers here from Sifka. He can pull out a really powerful demon to answer this.
Hellfire
first, yeah. And then trade in. Mm-hmm. And if he pulls out Jaraxxus, he might actually be in like a pretty good spot because he can defender that thing and keep it going for a while.
Whatever she pull out, it will be all very good.
I'm trying to think, what's the benefits of, outside of like obviously Mal'Ganis is just like insane damage and stuff, but like I think it's just too vulnerable to just removal spawns. Jaraxxus is so good against Druid. Mm-hmm. Here we go. 50-50.
Yeah, the combo.
Jaraxxus! Yes!
You face Deluxus!
That was cute. Finish it.
You face Deluxus. You face Deluxus.
No. I was looking for something else. You had me up until that point.
Swag a lot of the swag, Legion.
Your
Mortal Coil for a BGH, that's the obvious right play here.
Oh, yeah, I like that. Use the Mortal Coil and then get another Mortal Coil and then BGH.
Also, just Argusing afterwards, the Jaraxxus feels pretty good, man.
Yeah.
Try to kill that.
He's still got another Sunbury.
He can. 8 damage Boom Bots and Dr. Boom.
Whoa.
You called it. Wow, if you called that one. You're the wizard.
you know what's going to happen
if
when he hits his Boombot. You know what's going to happen.
But he drew a pretty good card. He drew a very good card.
Yeah, the Ancient
Watcher. He can double taunt. I suggest the double taunt. I will go for the double taunt.
I don't like double taunt. Like, you have double mountain giant in your hand. When will you play them?
But playing against Druid is about tempo.
I agree.
The Watcher can waste a lot of answer from the Druid.
But you're killing 2 cards in your hand. Like, maybe now. Like, just Argus.
But by setting up board preemptively, you have board tempo, therefore you can life tap.
Yeah.
So instead of the other way around. Instead of tapping into stuff, so that way you have the exact answer at the right time.
I know what a Watcher does.
Wow, Gar is salty.
Wow.
I'm just saying that there's 2 sides to the argument. No one's right, no one's wrong, Gaara. We're all happy little trees.
Yeah, I like
happy
that. I like
little
that.
Trees.
I like that nobody has BGH. Now we have a real game, man. Nobody's cheating.
It does feel kind of cheesy, right?
Right?
Whereas, like,
you play a, like your 9-9.
You meticulously plan turns and then it's just like BGH and I win.
Yeah.
I think you play the Belcher, right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Belcher is really good for complicating the combat math for Druid, but one thing that you have to be mindful of is next turn, he's going to force Nature's Savage or threaten the entire game. Actually, because the Emperored, and you know that 2 cards, if you're keeping count, are still reduced, then combo is always a threat from this point on. So you have to think, well, if I play such Belcher, do I die?
Yeah.
Does he have other choice?
Well, Belcher and Healbot heal for about the same amount of life. In fact, maybe even more for Belcher.
But the good thing is that if he can survive this turn, the next turn he has enough mana to play the Mountain
Giant. He could tap into BGH. If not, he plays Argus.
Yeah, that's true. BGH into Argus.
And you need to draw cards for your Mountain Giants. When you ever play those?
Oh,
he can play it next turn.
Oh my god.
Yeah, no.
And if he tap this turn, he can still play it next turn, but there's not much difference.
Dude, you draw Keeper of the Grove, that's so good.
The only difference is you could draw into BGH and...
He probably will save the Keeper.
Oh, and go for Drake Swipe instead?
Yeah, Drake Swipe is so good. Wow, so good.
Yeah, Drake Swipe is really nasty, and you put him at 8 life. Outside of Shadow Flame with the Molten Giant, there's really nothing that Handlock could do to come back. Wow, I didn't realize Stan Sifka's lineup was so vulnerable to Druid.
I told you, like 1 hour ago.
I told you Rackful will wreck Stasivka with Street like 3-0 or something.
Oh,
3-1,
man.
3-1.
What a way to advance.
Pretty sweet swipe.
I mean, he's not even going through the round of eight. He's going to the, he's gonna be oh, alright. Take less damage on his Ancient of Lore, that's fine.
And he already seen a Hellfire.
He doesn't want to trigger the Molten Giants.
Okay, where is the Shadow Flight?
Oh man.
Mountain Giant is pretty awkward now.
I think Rackful realized he could have done the swipe the other way. He could have killed the Belcher first and swiped the Ancient Watcher. And then attack face to him at 8.
Uh-huh.
Although, he does technically play around Shadow Flame and Molten Giants this way. And look, if he did, then Molten's would have been live. Would you like a Mortal Coil your own Sunwalker or Sun Fury here? So that you can get another chance for Shadow Flame?
Yeah, if he doesn't do anything, then he will die this turn. I think he will play Hellbolt. No mana for drawing cards.
Healbot, you still die to one Savage Roar, I think. Yeah, you do. By a huge margin.
You have to play safe now.
It's not safe. It's just you're doing nothing. Because he has so much damage just on board with these. I think he's got to go for Shadow Flame.
Oh.
Shadow Flame!
Oh!
That's not bad.
This is not...
But I think he's still dead. Because Keeper allows him to silence and then he can Force of Nature.
Yeah.
Wow. Rackful! Rackful's back!
So wrecked.
He's winning 2-1! Sifku gave him a chance and he is taking it.
Imagine?
Hey, you see what's on Stasivka's Warrior logo?
Yeah. It's a paradise. Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Frodan.
What's up?
Imagine someone went to a betting site and bet on Rackful. That emotional roller coaster.
Yeah, they're going through all the ups and downs. Especially if it is Rackful.
It's like, at some point in this series, Stasivka won the series.
Yeah.
That's how epic the series was.
I know. That's what's so crazy
Illuminati.
About it, too. Because we will count the result of the series.
Epic Amber.
Which is looking like Stasivka will take it, because he's got... Oh, actually, wait, he's got Temple Mage. What? Oh,
yeah.
I thought he had Freeze Mage.
He has a really cool Temple Mage, by the way. That's a really cool Temple Mage, because he's playing Idris Darkbane with spare parts.
Oh.
And he has double Mechanical Yeti and stuff like that.
I guess I didn't get to see that much.
It's pretty good.
I thought he was playing Freeze Mage. Why would he play Warriors?
I thought he was playing Freeze Mage.
What?
No.
So why do you think he picked Warrior into Druid?
Oh, if he's playing Freeze Mage, he will ban the Warrior, the Rackful's Warrior or Druid or something, right?
Yeah, probably.
Mm. It's very obvious it's not Freeze Mage.
I don't know, it's really late. He's got Wild Growth and...
Oh, baby, time to gamble again.
Here we go.
Oh.
Bankleaf.
Oh, that's pretty damn good.
That's a good card.
That's a good Aldo Peacekeeper, man.
That's so good.
That's a pretty good Aldo Peacekeeper, I would say.
He's going to be able to stop whatever gets innervated out. And you know what? That 3-7 body is nothing to scoff at. By the way, Eadric the Pure. Pretty cool. Pretty underrated.
Whoa. You see Rackful's.
Scammers. Dude, this game is full of shenanigans. Demon Heart? For the perfect tempo answer to Ancient of Lore.
He really rigged the RNG of that game.
Man. Well, you do have answers. He gave you a quick shot. Do you innervate out a 7 drop, though?
Quick shot feels pretty good.
I think he innervated before Mirror Entity come out.
That's a good point, but there's no scientist, and he could have played Mirror Entity. Well, I guess he wanted to play Spell Slinger for sure.
I like war, man.
Oh, I like
war.
No, he's Glowtheb and quickshotting.
Oh, I see.
That's
also...
That's not a very good tempo, I should say.
Well, that's zero tempo.
Like
it's tempo, but it's...
He played Glowtheb, why he killed the Mana Worm? There's no point in killing Mana Worm, and it's only like 2-3.
Right. That makes sense. Oh, that's pretty good.
I thought Eadric did every minion.
Oops,
I don't like
no,
this
it's just opponents.
Sorry.
That's
I don't
like
know.
An Elder Peacekeeper.
I don't play this card.
It's okay. So welcome to Hearthstone, Frodan.
Wow. So you know every single thing that every single card does in Hearthstone, at least off the top of your head.
At least I know this.
You okay, well I haven't played much of Eadric the Pure.
Oh, you play your Overwatch.
Better at you at Overwatch and Hearthstone. He's got two arcane missiles now and flame cannons, so that's a really big buffed up mana worm.
Well, we have a lot of RNG in this hand.
Yeah, although that's like dumping all of your hand pre Flame Waker.
Gonna cannon it up.
Yeah, buff the mana worm.
Cannon it up, it is.
Oh!
Oh, that feels really bad, man. Oh, Scamast. Scamast.
Oh, Wreckful. Getting owned by the Darnassus Aspirant drop.
Oh, boy. It's by far the worst draw.
Wow. Well, I mean, he's pretty far away from the seven drops now. I guess all that wild growth was for nothing.
I'm so curious why Stasivka don't use this mage last game.
Yeah, instead to answer the druid.
Instead he
is. Is he handicapping himself for Wreckful? Because having warrior to answer the hunter as a last resort would be really good.
And Wreckful has three seven drops, man. That aspirant.
Yeah. That aspirant to counter the wild growth, and now you have Emperor Thorsen uncontested. But you know what's the big savior of the game early on was that Eidric the Pure.
Yeah.
He stopped the big innervate tempo play from Wreckful.
Not bad.
Not bad at all.
Whoa.
Also reducing that. He can play all of that next turn.
All in.
Yeah, he's all in. Oh, man. I think Wreckful is toasty toast. He's going to find out next turn that he's going to need to scoop it up.
Wreckful is so soft. It's so funny.
Yeah, Stasivka is going to win the series.
Yo, we have Hunter versus Tempo Mage.
He can play all of that again.
That's good, man. Go for it, man.
Yeah. Flame Waker, Sorcerer's Apprentice. You play that Demon Heart for three, kill the Pilot Shredder, and then watch the fireworks fly.
And now...
Ping, ping. There it is.
Face is the place. Well played.
Wow. Oh, it was like going all face for a second.
Ping, ping.
Does he save the last one? It is 5 damage, it's kill command to the face.
Wait, if he plays... Oh, whoa. If he plays war here...
If he plays war, he's...
There's no lethal then.
Yeah, he'd be off by one.
But mage will draw damage, trust me.
Okay.
There's all damage in this
call
deck.
Call it.
There we go! There it is. Boom.
There it is.
Joking me?
Not even close. Ping the face.
Ping, ping.
The there it is.
Ping, ping.
Save some time.
Wow, it's tied 2-2. And we're making this one really dramatic. It started off crazy. It's going to end crazy. I think it's only fitting that we went the full distance here.
Yeah.
I think Ardu and Firebat, though, are really ready to play their next game. They've gotten a really long break. It's almost 11 p.m.
Wow.
All right, how are you guys doing? How are you guys feeling? I'm definitely feeling a little fatigued here.
Yeah. I want to go to the bathroom.
It took really long. Like, it feels forever. This was
and the lights are on us, too, so I'm, like, kind of sweating.
Like, how long is the series?
The series has been going on for about, I don't know, like...
2 hours? 3 hours?
1.5 hours.
Wow.
Maybe almost 2 hours.
Jeez.
Yeah. But on the positive side, we've had some really memorable moments. I don't think I'll forget this series for a long time.
Yeah, that was really fun. Yeah. And I hope they have a rematch.
I'm gonna take a swig of water. You guys feel the silence for a sec.
Oh.
Great job. Great job. Let's go to game 5. Hunter versus the Mage. We have a lot of opinions about this matchup, but what do you guys think? Gar, you're the Hunter player. What do you think about this matchup?
I think, like, it depends on how slow the Hunter is. The slower the Hunter, the more favored the Tempo Mage. The faster the Hunter, the more favored the Hunter, obviously. So it can, like, if it's mid-range Hunter, the Tempo Mage is, like, favored up to 60%. But if it's Face Hunter, the Face Hunter is favored up to 60%. So the more you, the more aggressive.
Then how about this hand?
The Mage hand?
Mage hand's pretty good. He's got coin and he's got Flame Waker with some shenanigans.
I like Mad Scientist from both sides a lot.
But Mage hasn't got one drop.
That's if there's a mana worm.
The freezing trap sucks. You never want to draw secrets ever.
Freezing trap.
East portal can do magic. Yeah, this mage hand is too slow. You really want mana worm. Like, mana worm changes the matchup so much.
Yeah. In fact, it changes every matchup so much. The fact that you can start off with it makes your hand much more explosive.
Oh, it's time to gamble. Oh, you wanted something cheap. That's
what?
Really good.
Whoa. That's so funny, the Dune Maul Shaman.
That's really... Oh, he will overload though, right? By how much?
Uh-huh. By one mana crystal.
One.
Oh, that, then you can't play it.
He also uses the coin.
Yeah, then you can't play it.
That's pretty sucks.
Look how much overload sucks. You can't even play one mana Dune Maul Shaman. Gorilla.
Yeah, Dune Maul Shaman, I think.
Dune Maul Shaman.
Yeah.
How much overload sucks.
If that, it's hard.
I have a question, Gar. If that card had no overload, would it be playable?
It's pretty damn good. It's like 4-5. It's just
5-4.
Yeah, 5-4 with ridiculous damage.
Okay. So the one overload makes it unplayable.
Like
though.
Most of the cards. A lot of the overload, yeah. Like Crackle is so good as a card.
Yeah.
But overload is just so bad. Like it just sucks.
He doesn't want to take too much damage though. But the problem is he doesn't have enough for Flamewaker coin yet.
Wow, he decided
but
not
hit
to
the
kill
ground. That's like the
Whoa.
Worst card ever.
Hunter doesn't draw.
How can you ever spend 3 mana on that crap?
You know what it does do? It activates a Flamewaker.
Oh, does he give Rockfall Unleash?
What? He gave him Unleash the Hounds.
No way.
No.
That's so funny.
That's pretty good.
No.
All right. Well, I'm ready to see some Flamewaker fireworks.
You go face. The opponent will trade. Will trade. You go face.
You have so much
Alpha.
You have Kill Command and Quickshot.
Yeah, you've got Unleash.
Alpha can't trade. It says so in the like the tooltip.
I don't know. I think his hand spells face.
Really?
Oh,
really?
Man.
Really, right?
Trade for.
Really?
Oh, man. And now if Flamewaker does its magic. Oh, no.
Magic boys.
Well, we're about to see this Flamewaker show you why this card is to be feared.
Okay.
So just as if the scientist.
Oh, that's.
Something
that's,
bad comes out. Oh, okay. Interesting.
Just
well,
okay.
Well, easiest abuse surgeon of his life, plus trap, plus hero power.
Yep, and then just give it back over.
Yeah, yeah. Clean the board before Hyman.
The board won't be clean, really. It's, you give him so much initiative. All you leave is a 2-1.
Yeah, just finish everything he needs to do before the Hyman turn.
Also, I'm not sure if Rifle played another trap, like 2 traps, but to reduce the chance of pulling a second freezing, if he has something else, he could play a freezing trap before it. Dune Maul Shaman. This card has a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. And, which basically means 100% chance, so you gotta always attack the thing that you don't want to hit. Or you... Yeah, you want to attack the thing you don't want to hit.
Mm-hmm.
Fastest Hyman.
So, if he wants to trade this in, he has to hit the face and it will hit the Hyman. That's the rules of the Dune Maul Shaman.
Oh!
Oh.
Wow, that was
perfect!
Oh! That was so sick.
Do you think that's perfect? Or do you think
Isn't
it's better to go face?
Yeah, I don't think he wanted to go face here. He can't go face.
But how does he deal with this 2-2?
Or does he deal
one
with the 6-5?
One Flamewaker is gone.
Wow.
One Flamewaker
was pretty perfect, though.
That was literally 50% too.
Yeah, to hit with the first strike face and then kill it, that's pretty good.
Yeah, good stuff. 2 kill commands.
You
now,
go super aggressive.
That is a hand that tells you to go face. Yeah. You might be afraid of what Flamewaker can do, but...
Nah. He's so on Flamewaker. He don't care.
I think he will use a boost or something.
How much damage do you even have right now? You have 10,
kill
12,
command.
16. You can put it at 4.
Whoa, kill command, freezing, hero power is the play. That's not a play. Come on, man.
He's got this, though.
He plays Hunter. You have to smirk.
But he plays Hunter at the end of the season.
Okay, he's going full smork.
Yeah, four damage, 4 health is fine.
All right, just...
It's
just,
fine.
Just go full smork.
And there's nothing Sivka can do. He just gets completely destroyed by the quick shots. And Wreckful, unless there's some magical top deck, which I don't even think is possible. Sivka's dead. What just happened? Wreckful's gonna win this series. No, Sivka was supposed to win. This is the worst plot twist ever.
Where's justice?
Oh, man. You know what? You know what? They're going to have a rematch in Decider. I definitely know that for a fact.
Oh, man. Imagine Wreckful in the winner's interview. Okay, I'm on a rematch now because he gave me the rematch.
Oh, God. That would be a really classy move, but no, no.
Yeah, and I can switch to some other people to cast, and I can go to the bathroom.
All right. Well, guys, it's been real fun, but Sivka knows that it's time. Unleash the Hounds, created by a Spellslinger, the BM.
Whoa.
Wow. He's going to even show it. Oh, man.
Really?
Wow, Wreckful. Have you no shame, sir?
How can you do this? How can you BM?
Oh. All right. Well, Wreckful is the winner of the series. He's going to join us for an interview.
There you go, man.
All right, well, a lot of questions.
He's thinking.
Yeah,
what he's
going
to say, his victory speech.
All right, he's going to go shake his hand first. So, you know, obviously.
They're hugging.
Kiss camera.
Kiss cam.
Wreckful is really, really thankful. I mean, we can always.
The X did it.
Oh, my God.
Stop. I'm sorry. Then maybe we'll see you again.
Yeah. Oh. Do it.
Kiss. All right, Sivka.
Okay.
Sivka
okay.
And Wreckful.
We're having more people on the couch.
It's a party.
Yo.
All right, so Wreckful.
Yeah.
What's going through your mind right now?
I feel kind of bad because, I spaced out in the mulligan that one time and he let me go again. So I let the whole mulligan go through without clicking. But that's all, I guess. Also, the kiss cam. Also, I feel stupid for not writing down that he didn't have another cruel task. That's
it
about
happens,
it.
Man.
Just feels bad, man, even though I won. That's life, man.
It does happen, man.
Huh?
It does happen that way. Like, you don't really get happy about your accomplishments if you played badly or something.
Yeah. It's so hard to go full try hard.
Well, you do
realize, so much work.
You do realize you have to play next series, too.
What?
You have to play again.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have to play again and write things down.
But now you actually can do this. You actually go into top 8. Win one more series.
It's cool.
All right, do you guys have any questions for Wreckful? He's been through a lot.
Gara, I love you guys, though.
Just,
you guys are all so nice to me. And you make me feel good, man.
My advice
even
is...
Even when I feel bad.
Just shake it off, like Taylor Swift says.
Yeah.
And with that, we are going to go
just
to
gonna
a commercial break.
Wait, are they hating?
Hate.
They're not
We're
going
to go to commercial break.
But, stay tuned. We will be
you're
back.
You're a good bro, man. Froden, I'm so proud of you,
Froden,
man.
Froden.
Going through, you're owning.
Hey, we all are, man.
Yeah.
And Wreckful.
Yeah.
We're winning. Good stuff. We'll be all back, right. Guys, with Wreckful versus RDU. Stay tuned.